Welcome, welcome, my beautiful Scorpios, my beautiful water sign. I'm Brenda Tarot, and I'm here again today to bring you your general tarot and oracle card reading for the week of February the 22nd to the 28th, 2021. I can't believe we're heading into the end of another month so quickly. Again, I want to thank you for your interest in my channel and for viewing, liking, sharing, and especially subscribing. It's free. If you like watching my videos, do yourself a favor, and it certainly supports what I do out here and the time and effort it takes all of us YouTube creators to do what we do to market ourselves. Please press the subscribe button and make sure you press the bell and make it ring too. Then you'll get notified immediately when any of my card readings are out here or when I go live to give out free messages. This is, as I said, a general reading. So all the information is posted below in the information box, prices, website, and email to contact me should you desire a private reading. Again, I truly want to thank all the generous, kind-hearted, and heartfelt donations that were given to me by you beautiful people towards my George and his surgery. He had his surgery yesterday, February the 18th, and it was a great success. So far, so good. He's still there, but he should be released tomorrow, and the vet was amazing. He's contacted me. I've spoken to them four times, and George is doing really well. So thank you so, so much for your kind donations for the cause, and I truly am blessed to have all of you in my life here. So let's get on with this reading and see what we have here for my beautiful Scorpios. Your all over energy card couldn't get any better. You have the sun, and this is a time of great joy and success, brilliant epiphanies that lead to magical opportunities, plans that work out perfectly, and gratitude to the divine. So you've always heard me say that the sun is the best card in the deck. Absolutely. It talks about you being able to see light at the end of the tunnel, being able to get noticed for what you do out there in the world. What you project out there into the universe is coming back to repay you and to reward you at this time. You will get noticed. I think you're dealing with people on an international level, some of you, and it's as though you're getting noticed for the brilliance that you have. You're lighting your own path, being able to make long-term positive plans now, and a sigh of relief. You're going the distance, and you know, people are watching you from the sidelines here, so this is beautiful. So always be sure to give grace and gratitude, for this is a beautiful card today to go towards your reading, and what a way, the best card of the deck. I mean, how many people get that? Not very many. So this is a beautiful card for you to get right off the bat, Scorpio. Your first energy card is culmination of vision. And this is about you, you know, taking time to take positive action towards your goals and your dreams. But in the meantime, you do have to be a bit adaptable, and maybe you've got to tweak things and fine-tune any of the details of what it is you're creating out there in the universe. And by doing that, you will see that you're going to get noticed, okay? So you may be changing things up in your job or your career around you, some of you. And I want you to reflect on your desires and make sure your attitude and beliefs are in alignment with what you wish to accomplish. Remain positive, okay? Let go of any aspect or quality that no longer fits what you intend to accomplish. And I think you did this a long time ago. I think you've walked away from a certain energy that wasn't helping you grow and expand and go in the direction you wanted to go for your personal success. Your next energy card is surrender your fear of change. The universe is reminding you that you are cared for always, whether you're afraid of a change in your job, your health, or a relationship. Or if you fear aging or death, repeat the affirmation, I have faith that all is well. So you're on this journey, Scorpios, and you know, don't ever let fear lead you on your path, no matter what you know, what has occurred to you in the past that you've had to walk away from. Know that you're going to be walking into a brand new beginning here. This is a beautiful new beginning for you. So it's gorgeous. So I, you know, don't allow fear to lead you on the path, because it cripples you. It holds you back. Don't reflect on those things. Don't dote on those things. Just look at the positive forward move you're making here. You've got the moon, and the moon is all about, you know, again, finding information out. Maybe there's something that's going on in the background that you need to know. Maybe you're researching something. Maybe, you know, you're having to find answers to questions that you haven't had answered yet. Know that the moon comes out at the darkest time of our day, and it illuminates absolutely everything around and below it. So you're going to be able to see the light. You're going to be able to move forward now in a positive direction. Don't get up in your head. Now, your crowning energy is great. This is the Two of Wands, and this is you, again, watching for your ship to come in, waiting for something to come in, going the distance maybe for your job, your career, working hard towards this beautiful passion and goal that you want to see come into fruition. Don't waver. Stay there. Stay focused. Keep going in that direction. You could be traveling a distance to go to your profession, your job. Maybe you're going to hear about a proposal, an idea, or something where you have to go and meet somebody at a distance. Maybe some of you are getting a job where you've had to move a distance to go and do your work. Some of you could be dealing with people on an international level, virtually, out there in the world as well. You could be traveling, planning a trip for pleasure or for business. Now let's see what we have here with, staying focused on your vision here. Well, you've got the King of Cups. The King of Cups is a beautiful king, male or female, has the ability to step up and give you heartfelt, helpful advice. Take it. This person is here to help you. Could be a water sign, Scorpio, another Scorpio, Cancer, or a Pisces that is stepping up to assist you with something. Maybe they've been through the same sort of a situation and they want to step up and give you advice. They do it and charitably. You could be doing this yourself, okay? You could be taking on this energy, Scorpio, of this water king, helping and nurturing other people, mentoring other people, teaching other people, guiding other people. And you could be getting involved in doing something for the less fortunate. Could be a charitable act that you're advocating for as well. Coming across again with your vision here, you've got reason to celebrate. The Three of Cups, again, I love all this water element that's showing up here across the board. You're going to be able to celebrate something. Great accomplishment maybe that you've made, sharing it with your friends, family, and those that care about you, or even maybe your clients. Whatever it is, it could be an announcement of some beautiful occasion or event as well. But get ready, my beautiful Scorpios, to celebrate. You've got some energy changing around you that something's going to come in very quickly and you're going to have to act on it. Okay, so it could be information, it could be, something legal, maybe it could be a partnership, it could be a document that you have to sign. Now, you can't wait around, you've got to act on it because it comes in quickly and you've got to act on it ASAP, but you need to read between the lines. You need to be careful what you're signing on the dotted line for. Be sure you know what you want before you sign and accept anything. Coming in with your surrender to fear, this is the Judgment card. You made a calculated assessment of what was going on in your past and you made a judgment call and you're moving on. It's rebirth. You're given a second chance to do what it is you want to do and be happy. Absolutely fantastic. Again, next to your crowning energy of the Two of Wands, you got the Nine. Now, the Nine tells me you might have been having to defend yourself for something that you personally created and put a lot of time, effort, blood, sweat, and tears and invested in. Don't back down. This is a card that says, do not give up, okay? Do not give up. Temperance. Temperance means things are going slowly here next to the Moon. Things aren't moving quickly here. Okay, doing things in moderation, taking your time. If you're recuperating from something, healing mentally, emotionally, spiritually, or physically, take your time. Okay, don't overindulge, don't overdo. This is the card of pause, and things aren't moving quickly right now, and you shouldn't push it. The High Priestess, yeah. You're going to be able to look beyond the end of your nose and perhaps see what's going on. Maybe some of you, because you're quite psychic and you're quite intuitive yourself, a lot of Scorpios do what I do out there. Again, another mutable water sign and sensitivity. You might be dealing with the other side, the spirit world as well. But you're going to be able to find information in the background and secrets are going to be revealed at the perfect time. This is being able to have this intuition, this gut feeling of what's going on in the background and tapping into it, doing your research to prove your theory. You're going to be able to do that. Now, as I had said to you, something here was coming in here very quickly and it could have been a legal situation you had to sign on. And you've been fighting and advocating for it, not backing down. And at the end of the day, look what you get. You get justice. Not only did you get judgment, but you got justice. So justice means that whatever you've been advocating for, fighting for, defending yourself for, promoting yourself for, it's going to work out in your favor. This is getting justice is going to be served and waived in your favor. I love it. Beautiful. Now, let's see what we have for confirmation for our Two of Wands. Keeping the vision and the door open towards prosperity, you have the Four of Coins. You know what? This is usually the card that says, you know, this is the extremes in which you spend your money, hold on to your money, or you know, spend your money or hold on to your money. But this is a card that says you need to keep your options open, keep your mind open. There might be a proposal or an idea that is presented to you in the near future that you might have thought you would never have been interested in. Go for it. Don't be afraid. This is a card that says be a little more open-minded, okay? Don't be afraid to step forward here and go towards your goals. All right. Our beautiful king. Not only do you have the king, but you you had the king, you didn't have the queen. You got the King of Swords. Oh, wow. Okay, so this could be somebody that's coming in not only to the King of Cups, but you could be dealing with, you know, legal higher ups, legal authorities, maybe judges, maybe, you know, lawyers, something here as well. But because they stand for legal, doing things right and above board and integrity and truth, this could be a situation where you're going to be dealing with that. But you're going to stand in your truth no matter what, my Scorpios. You're not backing down. You know, a judgment call was made. You're moving on in a new beginning towards your happiness, your garden of abundance here. Keeping your eyes open still, because she walks with the falcon with the hood on. And that means you need to keep your options and your eyes open as you head towards your goals here of prosperity. Temperance, taking your time, not going too quickly. You've got the Emperor. Well, yeah, the Emperor is a leader. Maybe you're planning on how you're going to make your move. You're planning on the next stage you're going to go. You're standing in your leadership here. You're your own independence, a solo, you know, power here. You know, you're stepping up into your power as an independent, excuse me. So, but you could also be asked to step up and maybe teach, mentor, or be a leader in something, stepping up to do that as well. But this is a great card. I love the Emperor. When he comes forward, he's able to step up and take control. So you're going to keep your emotions intact and you're going to be taking control of a situation. This celebration card with the Three of Cups, you've got the Queen of Pentacles. Now, she has this ability. I call her the Mother Earth. She has the ability to put her hands and plant her seeds and watch things grow. So you could be doing that. Maybe you're doing research. Maybe you're going back to school to get, you know, get a credit in something or learn a new form of study that you're going to be able to apply. And you're doing these little seed plantings now that's going to help you grow your abundance later. But it also stands for a celebration here of, you know, hard work and effort, or maybe the announcement of an impending birth, a child coming in, or even the birth of a business. So you're definitely to have that land on the celebration card, it could be that. You've got the, and on top of the High Priestess here, trusting your intuition, planting your seeds again. This is the Eight, working hard for your craft. So I do think you're taking, some of you are taking a something at school, an online course, or something that's going to enhance your resume or even add to your job, whether it's a passive side job or whether it's going to be a part of your job you have now. I do think you're working very hard, a lot of you, towards this gift, your craft, your job, your career, and stay focused and keep doing that, because then you're going to be able to move forward here and see the whole picture. Acting on this fast movement here with this Knight, you've got the Knight of Swords, you've got the Knight of Rods. So the Knight of Rods again comes charging in. And the Knight of Rods is the energy of, you know, the energy of fire, Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. But the Knight of Swords is air, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarian. So you could be dealing with any of those elements, any of those energies around you. Both of them are very quick moving. And this particular Knight of Rods comes in, it could be with an exciting idea that's going to get you all hepped up and excited to go and deal with. But it also has to do with a very quick arriving admirer that could be coming into your energy space as well. The Nine of Wands, defending yourself no matter what, is the Four of Swords on top of that. So you may have to step back and take some time out, pull back on something and rest here. But know that you're protected and that while you're there, you know you're safe and sound. Okay, the Four of Swords says stepping back, taking some time. You might have had to fight and advocate with that. with that situation where you're defending yourself. The Queen of Swords shows up on the Justice card. Absolutely. So she's the queen that, cuts through the BS, cuts through anything that doesn't serve her. A lot of people look at her as hard and crass and abrasive, but she's not. I like this queen. She has the fortitude and the insight to step up and say, you know what? I'm cutting all this crap out of my life. I don't need this, this storm around me anymore. And if it's not helping her grow and expand and go forward in a positive direction, she cuts it out. And I think you've had to see the truth in a situation here. And for some of you, it might have been in a relationship on a personal level, or it might have been on a business level, or it might have been a legal situation here. But you're cutting it out. You're cutting cords, and you're cutting out that situation. And at the end of the day, you didn't back down, and justice was served, and you come out ahead. It was waved in your favor, so it's all good. Well, Scorpio, you're still dealing with a lot of energy around you here this week, but at the end of the day, I think you're going to see success coming in. Reason to celebrate, moving forward, stepping up, being your own boss, taking control of a situation. And you know what? You got the best card in the deck. Your outcome card is the Sun and the beginning. Well, my beautiful Scorpios, this is your reading for this week, and I wish you a great remainder to today and a beautiful, optimistic week here to look forward to. And again, I always want you to remember that the universe and the divine, your higher power, want you to succeed, want you to find your happiness and your peace. So surrender to it and move forward towards your goals and happiness. Blessings, my beautiful souls, and know that I always and only stand in this circle of love and light for you. And my prayers and blessings are that you continue to play safe, stay safe, and be safe. And I'll see you soon.